The most widely used approach to encrypt a large message is CBC. It stands for Cipher Block Chaining. In CBC, the input to the encryption algorithm is the result of XORing the previous ciphertext block and the current plaintext block. To encrypt the first plaintext block, we use a so-called IV, stands for initialization vector, and we XOR IV with the plaintext block and give the input to the encryption process to produce the first ciphertext block. And then the first ciphertext block is used to XOR with the second plaintext block as input to the encryption process to produce the second ciphertext block, and so on and so forth. Again, in CBC, the current ciphertext block depends not only on the current plaintext block, but also the previous ciphertext block, which in turn depends on not only the previous plaintext block, but also the ciphertext block prior to that. In other words, in cryptanalysis, it is very hard to figure out the plaintext block just looking at the current ciphertext block. More importantly, if two plaintext blocks are exactly the same, meaning that they repeat in the same message or in two different messages, their ciphertext blocks are not likely to be the same. In addition, if an attacker attempts to swap in a different ciphertext block or rearrange the orders of the ciphertext blocks, the ciphertext is not going to decrypt properly into the plaintext. Here's how decryption in CBC works. A ciphertext block is decrypted, and then the result is XORed with the previous ciphertext block to produce the current plaintext block. For the first ciphertext block, after decryption, the result is XORed with IV to produce the first plaintext block. Therefore, the IV must be known to both the sender and receiver.